Writing, whatever it is, Lord, we bring you glory, multiply it and make it rich to the thousand souls, the farthest places, Lord. May you use people through this little material thing, but in your eyes, it will be big thing. May this moment, Lord, we also anoint the lips of the brother Francis, the Holy Spirit, that he will speak thy words, nothing else. Thank you so much. Hearing, answering our prayer. In Jesus' Nazareth, all we say, Amen.
Amen.
All of you. And,
magandang umaga po sa inyo.
I'm going to say, CR, hold it for me.
Just hold it.
Hey, this is running. I thought he already shot it, shooting right now. Okay, I thought he was posting it right now.
And I became a Christian. I was quite some time already because my friend, and nag-share ng gospel sa akin. And alam ko yung katotohanan na mas maraming errors sa Catholic Church. So, kailangan bumalik sa totoo. So, ngayon, sa pananulik siko, sa si God commanded us to seek first the kingdom of God and His righteousness. Kailangan tuloy-tuloy yung pananulik siko natin para we will grow in His grace and knowledge of Jesus Christ. Kaya nga, nangyari sa akin, kapag sa kuliksik ko, hindi ko alam kung paano ako napunta. But I believe it's about God's grace because hindi ko naman kilala si Father Francis. Ako ay naimbita lang ng mga Tondo pastor sa isang sharing at fellowship sa Tondo, which is composed of at least 30 denominations, Christian denominations, marami iba ibang lahat. So you can see na maaaring iba-iba rin ang kanilang mga paniniwala, but they all believe in Jesus Christ in different ways of peace. But anyway, nangyari ngayon, that through the Tondo pastor, I was invited sa Heritage, sa isang fellowship seminar ni Frank Ewald. Si Frank Ewald is a German missionary. Dati siya Nazi. At that time, siya yung sinukonsider na youth Nazi in here. So you can just imagine kung anong itura ni Frank Ewald. No? Malaking tao. Kasi 85 years old na siya, malaking tao. Blue eyes. matangos ang ilong, diba? Very, very fierce looking, no? At gano'n ang mga itura minsan ng mga German, diba? At very noble, no? But at his age, Franz Ewald was going around 32 countries, maski gano'n na siya katanda. And Franz Ewald is a contemporary of William Branham, kung alam si William Branham, considered by Christendom as a prophet for our age, because he was anointed by God, and these are documented, and he made a lot of miracles, documented din yan. Hindi lang nakarating sa Pilipinas, kasi itong time na yun, may war, 1940s, 1950s. Kaya kung may interview tayo ng mababasa kay William Branham, maganda. And then ang nabubuhay dyan si Frank Ewald, testify nga sa heritage. Ngayon, from heritage, I met Brother Francis. He was the first guy there, parang siyang una. At pinausap niya ako. And he invited me to see him or hear his radio. Until nagkabalik, he invited me to Quezon for a 7-day minister's retreat. At hindi ko alam na may fasting pa siya. I was not prepared. So for 2 days, mas fasting kami. Parang ako sa fasting. At water lang yung aming sininom. So medyo maganda dahil I lost siguro mga 10 pounds.
Francis, fasting din noon, hindi?
Napapasting pa rin ako, Sema. Kasi I eat only once or twice a day. Doon yun, dala ko lang sa akin. Parang okay na sa akin yun.
Pero may rule yan, fasting. I know the procedure. Hindi pwede basta close your mouth. That is considered sin. You must know, you must covenant, you must have covenant with God.
I don't know that.
Oh, it's not like that, yeah.
I don't know
in
that.
The O-O.
So, that means I just do it out of my sincerity.
Accepted in the eyes of God. Accepted, yeah.
Fellowship.
Yes.
So nung nagturo na siya, Brother Francis, doon marami ako natutunan. Natutunan ko yung mga church ages, right? Church.
Seven churches, ages.
The Revelation, yung mga episodes, yung mga Sardis, Smyrna. Kung nagbabasa niya na sa Revelation niya, I thought all the while, ang pagkakaalam ko dun, they are simply characteristic of churches, which is also true that characteristic ngayon.
Opo.
But I discovered they are periods in the church history.
Period, ah?
They are periods, they are ages.
Yes.
So, lalong luminaw nang nabasa ko yung itinuro nila yung mga parables. Starting with the parable of the sower.
Sower, Matthew 25.
There are 7 parables taught by this, by the Matthew 13, by starting the Matthew 13. And I found out, I learned, na itong palang mga parables correspond with the church ages.
Amen, amen.
And this is something new to me, and it was revealed during that time.
Yeah.
Ang ganda, no? Kasi naka-discover ako ng treasure, eh. So, I found out that Jesus was the sower, the mother of all parables, yung parable of the sower, di ba?
Yeah.
Ang sabi ganito, the seed thrown by the sower, by Jesus Christ, the Matthew 13, is the word of God.
Amen, amen.
Is the word of God, Matthew 13.
Yes, yes, Matthew 13.
The word of God. So, yung pagsusow ng sower na yon at the time, is considered the time of Jesus.
Amen.
Kasi at the time, he was sowing the word of God to
yes.
Jesus, di ba?
Yes.
Okay. And after that, the apostolic period, yung Jesus, di ba, na the apostles now, having learned the truth from Jesus Christ, shared and told the gospel, the word of God, to the Jews and Gentiles with Paul, di ba?
Yes.
Okay. So the truth was shown in the times of Ephesus, no? So ngayon, nung namatay yung mga apostles, eh, pinaliwanag ng parable, ito na nga yung parable of the leaven, di ba?
Leaven.
Nagkaroon ng lebadura yung mga turo, nagkaroon ng mga errors na aluan. Parang sa tinapay, nilalagyan natin ng yeast, di ba?
Yes, para magka.
Mag-iiba yung lasa o yung make-up o yung quality ng tinapay. Di ba? Na aluan siya. Hindi na siya uneven bread, di ba? Palaging sinasabi ni Jesus, I am the bread of life, di ba? Truth, hindi siyang walang halo siyang kasinungalingan or errors. So, ganun lang nangyayari, no? Until pumasok tayo sa panahon na nawala yung truth, hindi na, walang masyadong tumatayo sa kapakanan ng pagpapahayag ng salita ng Diyos, lalong-lalo na nahalaan ang truth, lalo na nung pumasok ang
Nicolaitan.
Diba, yung mga Nicolaites, tapos yung Roman Catholic Church,
yeah,
ang nahaliwanan. Ruby, Emperor Constantine.
Amen, 325.
Constantine, hindi ko rin alam doon, pero na-research ko, si Constantine direct na mananalo siya sa lahat ng laban niya against pagans, kung lalagyan niya ng cross yung kanyang shield. Which he did. Nilagyan niya ng cross yung shield at nanalo siya sa lahat ng laban niya sa mga pagano. So, sabi niya, to thank the God of the Christian service, I will now forgive the Christians. I will not kill them anymore. I will tell them to come out of their hidden places, ganun katagong Christians, pinapatay eh. Diba? And tell them, oh, pwede na kayo lumabas ngayon because your God has helped me in my war against pagan. Diba? So ngayon, ano nangyari? Lumabas na yung mga Christians. Kaso, the Roman Empire said, oh, sige, pwede kayong mag-celebrate ng mga feast ninyo,
yes,
o yung mga paniniwala ninyo, pero pwede isama nyo rin ba yung sa amin? Kaya maraming feast, Roman feast, pagan feast na naalo sa Christians at the time. Isa na dun yung Christmas ng Kristiyano kuno na naalo yung pagan na rite ng Saturnalia ng Roman Empire. Eh, ang ano yun, yung feast na yun, eh, orgiastic yun. Ibig sabihin, debauchery yun, kainan, lasingan. There was orgy in the Roman Empire during the month of December. Eh, hinalo ni Constantine yun sa Christians, na nung panahon na yun, dun pinanganak si Christians. Para yung mga Christians, saka Pegas, mag-unite sila, mag-celebrate sila ng Christmas.
Yeah.
So that's a lie.
Yeah.
That's a lie by the Roman Church, di ba? So after that, the period went to a 1,000 years of dark ages.
Sa diliman.
Lumabas yung mga crusades against Christians, di ba?
Yeah.
Sila Charlemagne, sila pinapatay nila yung mga Christians.
Gamit nila cross, diba? Crusaders.
Cross, no? Naalala nyo yung sino ba yung babaeng nurse? No, na Joan of Arc, di ba? Sa siyata crusades, di ba?
Yep.
Pinapatay nila yung Christians. So natago ang katotohanan ng Thousand Ages.
Mas.
Hindi lumabas yan.
Yeah.
There are only a few.
Yeah.
Until nung panahon na hindi ko lang alam kung Sargamos ba, Teatira. Na lumabas si Luther.
No? Sardis.
Luther was a Catholic bishop.
Panahon ni Sardis.
Panahon ni Sardis yan.
Oo, Sardis.
Si Luther nandun yan.
Yeah.
Katoliko yan si Luther. But he was inspired by God.
Yes, amen.
By Luther.
Messenger of God.
Oh, he was
star of God.
He was the messenger for the truth.
Yes.
That
lumabas kayo dyan sa Catholic Church.
Amen.
Kasi maraming silang sinasabi na ganito sa inyo na hindi katotohanan. Kaya nga sumulat siya at ipinako niya.
95 pages of thesis niya.
95 pages.
Yeah. His thesis, graduation. Oh.
Against the
Catholic.
Catholic Church. Meron bang gagawa sa atin noon?
Wala, matapang na gano'n na yun na araw.
Pag-andes, talaga, nasa puso natin. No?
Called by God.
Marami ng church fathers ang lumabas.
Yes.
No? From,
simula na Protestantism started. Lutheran, Lutheran.
John Wesley.
Wesley.
Diba? At, ngayon,
John Knox.
Knox. Diba?
Campbell.
Ang period tayo ng Laodicea.
Yeah.
Ang period ng Laodicea is the seventh church age. The last stage na sinasabi sa Bible.
Yes.
Na ito na yon. Before the second coming of Christ.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
So, ngayong panahon, ngayon na tayo magsisik talaga ng ating faith.
Yes.
Wala na yung lukwan-lukwan.
Wala.
Kailangan tumutok na tayo, I am a Christian.
Amen.
I am a follower of Jesus Christ. I have God as my Lord and Savior.
Bible, notebook, pencil.
Kasi nga, yung apostol, yung panahon na to, ito na yung nagkaroon ng revival in 1906 ng mga Pentecostals, no? Yung Pentecostals, di ba? Protestant noona, then Pentecostals.
Yes.
Di ba? At marami ng katuruan ng mga lumalabas, yung iba, pinapahayag yung truth ng Panginoon. And remember, in all denominations, may katotohanan.
Amen, amen, amen.
Meron ding errors.
Yes.
So, ibig sabihin, kung tayo nagsasaliksik, di ba, dahil like sa masters, maraming ibong naka, ano, sa tangkay, at sa mga ano, isa tayo sa mga ibong yun. Di ba? Yung ibon na maraming, mas maraming katotohanan, at konting error, merong ibon na kukonti ang katotohanan, maraming error. So, tayo magsasaliksik ngayon na ano ba ang mga katotohanan ng Diyos na pinapakita niya ngayon na ibinabalik niya sa atin doon sa apostolic period.
Amen. Pure church. Early church.
Early church.
Yes.
Noong unang panahon, yung katotohanan natin.
Yes.
Ang katotohanan na sinuro ni Jesus,
yes.
Ang katotohanan na tanggap ng mga apostolo at ng kanyang mga disciples na natabunan noong dark ages,
yes.
Na ngayon ay pinapahayag sa atin.
Amen.
So nagpadala ngayon ang Diyos na mga prophets in our time.
Yes.
Para sabihin yung kanyang saloobin, ang kanyang katotohanan. Kaya meron tatlong katotohanan noon na ipapahayag si Brother Francis.
Amen.
At marami pang iba yon na based doon sa revelation ng mga prophets na ito ngayon. Sa Laodicean age, even before the second coming of Christ. So, Brother Francis, can you continue? Thank you very much.
I will continue ito, Brother Francis.
Yes. Oh. I focus more on the Lord than on me. By the way, I'd like to apologize if I look kanina. Pero pag nagsasalita pa ako wala namin. I didn't sleep last night.
Ah.
I very serious. And I didn't give them away my DVDs. Okay. Basically, for beginners, I share restoration message.
Amen, amen.
Now, but I can do it shortcut and have some interaction. I'd like to give tracks, and you ask questions. I'll write all the topics here, I'll give the tracks away, then ask questions. Through question-answer, we can cover more topics. We cannot cover all the topics. It has to be a series. It's a very long series.
Modules.
I've been in Fugueo since 1998, and even after I teach the basics, there are many new revelations to come.
Amen.
If you're gonna teach the new revelations, parang God's revelation is always new.
Amen. Amen.
It's progressive. So, it's very hard to compress, to catch up. You can only catch up if you do it yourself. You'll be given drafts, DVDs, you research for yourself. And the fastest way to learn is asking questions.
Amen.
You ask questions by yourself and set another time. But right now, I'm going to give some basics. Let's open our Bibles to Matthew chapter 13, verse 51, 52, and 53. And whoever will lead, I'm going to shoot it.
So you can write. Okay. Matthew 13, 51, 52, 53. Sister Tess, that's what?
Yeah.
Okay.
Neneng
ba? Neneng?
Neneng muna.
Ah, Neneng.
Okay. Verse 1 po. Ah, 51. Pinagunawa baga ninyo ang lahat ng mga bagay na ito, sinabi nila sa kanya, oo. At sinabi niya sa kanila, kaya ang bawat iskriba na ginagawang alagad sa kaharian ng langit at tulad sa isang taong puno ng sambayan at pambahayan na naglalabas sa kanyang kayamanan ng mga bagay na bagong at luma.
Okay. Thank you. These are
what I call things new and things old. Okay? What are the things new? What are the things old? Now, since I'm going to shortcut it, I'm going to share restoration next time. But I'm going to summarize all the old things and all the new things that has been revealed. And what's the purpose of that being revealed? Some people are not interested in big revelations from the Word of God. It is for the perfection of the bride. Those that will be wed, those who will be taken up by Jesus Christ, they're called the bride of Christ. The church would have become the bride.
Amen.
And the bride will become a wife.
Amen.
If you don't go through this process, you're not going to be saved. You can be saved here in the tribulation period, but that's a delay. You'll suffer. Now, this is the process how you become a bride. These revelations, things old and things new. Now, other things I purchased for this hidden things and lost things. Okay? Why is it called lost? Because there was a time it gradually disappeared. These are the basic apostolic doctrine.
Amen. Amen.
So I'm going to write it down in order how they were lost. First thing that was lost was the Godhead. What is God? Is He three? Is He one? Okay. What is His nature? Can He become a man? Or He just indwelt a man?
Si Ama. Ama.
So Godhead is talking about God.
Yeah.
Inside Godhead there is Christology. Okay, so after the Godhead is baptism.
Yes.
In Jesus' name. Please, pause. Pinutimig kita, pause.
Ha?
Hello, hello. Nasaan ka na?
Paano po si ito?
Ay, pwede ka mga. Hello, hello? Hello?
Hello?
Okay. So, the last thing, let's continue, no? The lost things, first things that was lost is the understanding about God.
Laligay mo M, baptism, M.
The baptism, the Godhead is so important, you know why? The pagans, the Gentiles, they don't know God. The Jews will introduce God to them. So when they introduced God to them, they introduced also Jesus Christ. And 100 years later, 200 years later, they turned the Godhead into a tree. Okay? So, the Godhead is very important. The Godhead is the first doctrine or revelation that was lost, that was changed. They debated on it in the Council of Nicaea. So, before the Catholic Church ever became a church, there was a debate on the Godhead. On the Godhead, when they voted for Trinity and the beginnings of the Catholic Church started. I'm talking of the organized Roman Church.
Minsan,
I'm talking of universal church.
Minsan Tagalog muna din, Brother Frank. Minsan lang.
Okay.
Tagalog and English.
I like speaking English.
Ah, ganun ba? Okay.
Saka, I put this on YouTube so that others can see.
Okay.
If it's in English, I can invite.
Okay. English, okay.
Now, if I say something in English, you don't understand, raise your hand. Okay. I also want to teach my members in Tokyo to speak English.
Yeah.
Now, Brother Alex can help me.
Okay.
Now, after the Godhead was changed, then the Trinity was changed. The baptism was changed. Maybe you are familiar with baptism in the Trinity. Let me give you the verse. Matthew chapter 28, verse 19. Okay? Matthew chapter 28, verse 19. That was the scripture they used.
And we can look for readers. Any volunteer readers?
Therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Great, thank you.
So, baptism in the titles of the Father, Son, Holy Ghost after 100 years. The Godhead was changed around 300 AD. And this baptism in Jesus' name was changed somewhere around 400. So, there was a falling away in the revelation, in the doctrines. These are almost all the doctrines. And the rest came, just going to write them down, justification by faith, predestination, eternal security, sanctification, gifts of the Holy Ghost Spirit, baptism of the Holy Ghost, and the most controversial doctrine to restore the original sin. This is controversial among churches, denominational churches, because the original sin is taught by others. Majority of the churches believe in the Trinity, the Godhead. Majority of the churches baptized in the idols of the Trinity. Majority of the churches also believe in the literal fruit, in the literal eating of the fruit from a literal tree. So, these are the major doctrines. Okay? And this was lost. This was lost. And those that I underline are those subjects you might not have heard of yet. These other subjects you may have already heard. It might not be at least you have an idea. Let's go to the hidden things. The things new and things old. This is Matthew 13:51. So you can come here. So the whiteboard. If it's reflecting light, you can change.
Oh, I'm making.
I know this will be in YouTube. You can tell your friends, your loved ones to watch anywhere in the world when this place is there. Okay. Things new. Hidden things. Things that was not yet revealed even in the time of the apostles. Let's open our Bible. One of the scriptures is Daniel chapter 12 verse 4. Open up our scriptures in Daniel chapter 12 verse 4. And is your name David?
Another person. Okay. Another, not Sister Charlie.
Maybe Brother
Joseph. Did you read for us? Daniel chapter 12 verse 4. Daniel chapter 12 verse 4. You don't have any, no?
Nothing.
Daniel 12 4.
The things which you mentioned, yeah. Something. The things.
New things and old things.
No, the things which were not
revealed in the time of the apostles.
The things which
that were hidden from the beginning.
Daniel, ingatan mo. Ingatan mo. Una ang mga salitang ito at isara mo ang aklat hanggang sa takdang panahon. Marami ang magsasaliksik upang tumuklas ng karunungan.
So, seal up the book. No? What is that book? Daniel was asking questions. And the answer to the question won't be given until the time of the end or the end time. Okay, so Daniel was asking verse 9, continue. Could you text brother, could you hold? Verse 9 back.
Address.
He replied, go your way, Daniel, because the words are up until the time of the end.
Okay,
dapat meron ka assistant brother Francis eh. Oo.
Then no, they can direct this.
No, ito.
Ah, oo nga pala.
Babad may assistant ka. Kasi,
okay. So, we read Daniel 12. I am not speaking all about. Eh, things na hidden, na-reveal the last days. Nagtaga mo na naman mga scriptures, just reading later. Eh, hidden mystery. These are hidden mysteries. So, marami pa iba. Pero, these are the mysteries. The revelation in the last days. The book of Revelation is a book of symbols. Most of the hidden mysteries are there. It's also tied up in the Old Testament. Para siya mong nag-guide. So let's write some of them. Seven church ages. What Brother Roger was saying a while ago? Seven church ages. Then seven shields. Seven weeks of Daniel. I think I told you na 7 Adventists, pero may difference. I can underline this para pag-usapan natin what's the difference, okay? Tapos, then virgins. Why is it virgins? Pero pare kayo, dali ko lang dito. 7 trumpets. 7 vials. So, 7 churches or 7 thunders. 7. Meron pa yung the 2 prophets. And 144,000 in tapos, may turo sa extra. Yeah, you can use 11R. I think Barbara mentioned 11R. Pero hindi lang parang major topic dito. I can expand it, pero sarili lang yan. I'm referring to what Brother Patrick taught. But there are other revelations that it is continuous coming up. So, he mentioned about 11-hour worker. I believe, kasi nag-aaral din sa, Brother Branham is reading from Adventist books. So, there was a time of teaching, Adventist teaching, but the angel corrected him. Hindi lahat tama. Meron inayos. Like yung first horse rider. Sa teaching na Adventist in his Christ. The angel corrected him when he was teaching on the seals. It's the Antichrist.
Personal.
The first horse rider is the Antichrist. So, ano pa? Malimutan na.
Restoration. Ito lahat restoration.
Of course, restoration, hindi pa napapag-usapan noon sa time na apostles. Fivefold ministry.
Fivefold, yeah.
Isa sa mga i-restore. And, yung ministry ni Barbara. Second Elijah. For the Gentiles. Malachi, chapter 4, verse 5 and 6. Okay? What else? Yung 666, yung Pope of Rome, alam naman lang yan. May nalala ko. Anyway, this is some of the major revelations in Brother Branham. Beyond Brother Branham, meron pa. But I don't write it here. Kasi masyadong detalye, masyadong makapag, masyadong parang. For example, prehistoric form of Lucifer. He talks about the angels, the dinosaurs. This is beyond the time of Eden. No, pa. Okay, that's
Melchizedek.
He talked about Melchizedek.
It is one of the great issues.
Oh. Then, while I'm distributing, prepare your questions, if you have. You may raise your hands, you may write in the paper. Whether or not, you can pause it now. Get back.
You understand the Parham,
as we can say, in the media? Not necessarily. The understanding of Parham. Kasi matagal po na sila ka-sharing eh. Naka-radio pa sila. Actually, bago pa kami nagra-radio, kami napunta sa radio nila para mag-debate si Romay Mahal. So,
sabadista
siya. So, dinala ako sa radio, debate ko sa SDA. So, later, nung magka-radio kami, SDA, sila nagka-debate namin. So, before I debated them, I've been reading their literatures na. May alam na ako dun sa 2003. Brother, ang 2300 days, hindi na years, no? Hindi galing kay Miller lang. Si Archbishop Usher.
Sila yung nagpura
kaya
sa
ikinamit.
I think, no. Yung October 22 na yan, yung 44 na festival ng Pang, ayun, ano ba na yun? Doon naman, ano, nag-mechanism na yan.
Alin dito?
Ah,
yes. This is different from 2003.
Yes, ano time, ano yan, di ba?
This is,
For short of the century of the
490 years.
Pero pag may ganyan yung 2000.
This is where...
At short siya, no?
Yes, the 700 is draws this type. The 70 weeks, and this is the 2000 days. Okay? So, of course, may time, tanong yan, I can share the error here. And the error here. Okay? The application of 2000 days. So, balik tayo kay Barbarnam. Barbarnam talks about this because it's one of the revelations given by God to him. Okay? Initially, parang carry over then 700 days teaching because they are not peers ministry in Christ, half of the week. Okay? Pero when the angel, he was teaching them all the time. Pero pagdating at a certain point, she prayed for him that he will talk on the subject. God showed him it's not 3.5 years na titira. There's 1 week left or 1 7-year tribulation left for the world. Okay? So later, we'll ask about that. Sige, anyone may wish to ask? Hindi mo lang mabigay. Baka, literally record. Tawag na. Pause muna, hatang muna.
Hindi ko sa'yo.
I want to talk about this. If I underline, you sabihin, you are familiar with the topic. Definitely, you're familiar. Siguro ito ngayon konti sa SDA.
Hindi na alam nila. Iba yan. And they are not...
Yeah,
be
ready. So, anyway, kung muna underline, quick na pag-aralan sa kanila. So,
ito original scene, yeah.
Okay, Bible.
Running.
Okay. Bible ministry talks about the ministry of the apostles, prophets, evangelists, pastors, speakers. They did not disappear. They just continued until the end. Okay, let's open our Bibles for the 5 more minutes. Ephesians chapter 4, verse 11. Yes. Ephesians chapter 4, verse 11.
Sister Yuri. You read? Chapter 4, verse 11. Yes.
At ang iba'y ginawang apostol, ang iba'y propeta, at ang iba'y evangelista, ang iba'y pastor at guro.
I think I made a mistake.
Bakit?
This is not something old. Hey, this is not something hidden.
Yeah.
This is not something new. This is something old that was lost. This was lost. You know why it became lost? When the Protestants came out of the Catholic Church, they thought it was over. No more apostles, no more prophets, no more evangelists. Pastor teachers. But as they grew to the end time, unti-unti sila nagkaroon ng pastors. Unti-unti na sila naniniwala sa evangelist. At ngayon, naniniwala na sila may prophet. And mga Pentecostal churches, they believe in the apostleship na. Like that, that gift, no, the ministry exists. Pero there was a time they believed that ministry ipas na. It was passed away. It doesn't exist anymore. So it was something that was restored. The message of restoration restores the original apostolic doctrines. That's one of the apostolic doctrines. It was taught in the Bible how God would give fivefold gift to the church. The tenure gifts, I can give a shortcut na nabasa niyo na ba, Matthew 25?
Yes, 25 verse 1 to 13.
Okay. The wise, yung progressive, they have extra oil. The foolish, they did not have extra oil. What does the extra oil represent? Progressive revelation. The oil represents the Holy Ghost. So the Holy Ghost of those who did not take extra oil will run out. And they are the denominations that stop not on revelation. I'll give you a scripture, no? Hebrews chapter 6, 1, 2, 3, 4. We can open it up and read.
Hebrews
chapter 6,
verse
1, 2, 3, 4. 5. So, let's shoot others.
Neneng, ikaw basa. Para kita na mamamo sa TV.
As the Hebrew you speak, verse 1 to 5. Yes. Kaya tayo'y tumigil na nang magsasalita na ang mga unang simulain ang arang ito. At tayo'y nagpatuloy sa pasakdalan. Na huwag natin ilagay ang muli ang kinasasaligan ng pagsisisi sa mga patay na gawa at ang pananampalataya sa Diyos. Nang aral na tungkol sa mga paglilinis ng pagpapasong ng mga kamay at ang pagkabuhay na muli ng mga patay at ang paghukom na walang hanggan. At ating gagawin ito kung ipinahintulot ng Diyos. Sapagkat tungkol sa mga minsang maliwanagan at kalasak ng kalooban ng kalangitan at ang nakabahagi ng Espiritu Santo at nakalasak ng mabuting salita ng Diyos at ng mga kapangyarihan ng panahong darating. Verse 6. At saka naghiwalay sa Diyos at baguhin sila muli sa pagsisisi. Yamang kanilang ipinapapakong muli sa ganang kanilang sarili ng anak ng Diyos. At inilalagay na muli siya sa hayag ng kahihiyan.
Okay, thank you. So let us therefore go to perfection. Not like again the foundation of repentance from good works and from baptisms laying on of hands and my basic teachings. There are churches that paulit-ulit lang sa basic teachings. Although not all teachings are correct, some churches suppress and partial truths, they won't get it right, all of them. Pero there are some churches na they don't focus much on deeper doctrines or revelations. Ang nangyari, mababaw na lang. The Bible says the dog going backwards about it.
The dog going
from Virginia to. These are the people, they are the people of God. But then, mas kulang sila ng kasi nila approach. Alam nila yung kapukuhanan, ang mabog ito, maaaring nandan, ito na, nasa kanila na ito.
Partial truth. When I underline this.
They may even have all truth, pero wala sila.
They may have, let's talk about truth. They may be 100% truth in a certain time. Because truth is progressive. What God reveals in a certain time, if you can get it all, you have 100% truth. They may have 100% truth in a temporary time, but if they are not berean or progressive in revelation, that 100% will gradually shrink. Because as God reveals more truths, maiiwanan sila. I'll give you an example. In the time of Martin Luther, the original doctrine of the Godhead was not yet fully revealed. So, they're all Trinitarians. So what God has revealed is that the judge only by faith, the temporary mountain, the temporary loss. So you may know all these things, what the reformers have revealed. You may not understand noon pala mali ang Trinity, none of them knew. So in the eyes of God, what He has revealed, you're accountable for that. That's what I call 100% truth. 100% truth meaning what God has revealed truth in you, in your time, you've accepted it, you are 100% truth. In Corinthians 13, you can read, having all knowledge, but without love. No?
Nothing.
So what happens? That you have 100% truth, you have all knowledge, but you will fall away. Hebrews 6, falling away is not going back, just backsliding to the world. Falling away is you stop walking. So as the light goes on, you're left behind. Your technology gradually becomes obsolete. Before we have computer or cell phone, long time ago, like this thing, you're the latest gadget. Kaya ka lang yung cell phone. But right now, the cell phone is small. Tapos hawak ko pa rin yan, malaki. You're obsolete. Oh, pager, beeper. There was a time that was the fad, no? The latest fad. Pero, as time goes on, it's impractical anymore. And mas mura pa yung cell phone kaysa beeper, mahal-mahal. So, that's what I was saying. What the fuck? I was saying that the 100% truth is for a time. You got it right at the time you have. Your attitude has to be Berea, so that as God continues revealing, you follow the light. You still maintain your 100%. Tagalogin natin. Nung nagpapahayag ng dagdag ng pahayag ng Diyos, yung tao kailangan bukas Berea siya para matanggapan niya yung dagdag na pagbabago. Hindi matatapos ang pahayag ng Diyos hanggang hindi mga saluta. Pag-usapan natin 10 virgins. Iniintay nila yung bridegroom.
Iba ito ang sabi mo kasi yung revelation they had continued revelation. Pero ito ay elastic, ano ito ba?
continue the revelation.
Last days na ito, di ba?
Sa teaching ni Barbara ng last days yan.
Pero?
Although, siguro meron na teaching na pwede apply yan ni Barbara ng SC. Pero pwede ko sabihin, kukoto mo na si Barbara ng he applied this in the last days.
Yes.
Kasi, the time Virgin, when among the, eto na, isa kong pag dito yun, pag-aaral sa time Virgin. Diba, may call the bride won't come in. The bride won't come in. Somebody shouts to the Virgin. So, ano, ito dapat ang, diba, ito dapat ang mag-shout yung mga Virgin?
Ang shout yung prophet, yung malaki for life yung prophet.
Pero, ang ano, the angel, ang mag-preach about the Lord is to prepare the way. Diba yung prepare the way? Alay dyan. Ang aking ano dito, the people who are preaching of the second coming are the ones
midnight, right?
Preparing for the
it's like this. Not everyone can be the midnight cry because it's like this. In the last days, the end times, we're talking of the time when the Lord will return in our generation. This will be a specific message, a specific person. There will be a message that came from a person, kaya na nag-asasin, kinagalingan nito. Fulfillment of this ministry. Malakai 4:5-6 is the forerunner of the coming of the Lord. This is a forerunner.
Yeah. Those who are preaching the...
Yes, yes. There is a particular person. In the first coming of Christ, it was John the Baptist. It's not the SNS or different people. So. It's a specific person that carried the message. Even after he died, that message continues on. So here in the Gentile realm, there is a person that was used in this ministry to bring all these things back.
Coming then, could be Ellenite.
Yes, you can think of Ellenite, pero you have to look it up. If it was in the time of Ellenite, wherein the coming of the Lord will take place. Pero, if the coming of the Lord takes place in our generation, it's someone just in our generation.
Yes.
Well, it's not the same person.
Not the same person.
No, like, it's not the same person.
Sabi kong Elijah sa Gentile already came and went. That's why we have this. At the top of the Jew. Sa Jew, we're built up na Elijah ministry, a specific person. He's kapartner pa niya si Moses. I'm not talking of a actual Moses, Elijah of old. They have the anointing of Elijah and Moses. Like John the Baptist had the Elijah anointing Elijah. These will seal the 144,000. After they kill the 144,000, the 144,000 will carry the everlasting gospel to the rest of the world before the end comes. So, ganun din dito. Bago ko maituro ito, if kahit lumalim pa ulang pa si Barbara, I have to learn this first. It has to come from someone. It has to be revealed from someone. And God uses a person
Sugo
to start that revival before others could receive the continuation. Okay, saka ko na i-detali ito. Balik ako dito sa sa teaching ni Barbara. Yung wise virgins will be taken up. The foolish virgins will be left behind. And they will be martyrs. But they will be saved.
For what?
Foolish.
Foolish?
Yes. Well, let's read that. Okay, let's read that. Revelation chapter.
I
had the teaching. Hindi teaching ni Barbara ba? Personally, I believe there are foolish people that will be wicked.
Pero that, I think that in kung balikan natin yung parable of the virgins, So, ang sabi niya, I don't know you. They were not able to enter into the ship with the wedding.
I'm gonna show you the Foolish Virgins birthday sa Bible. I'm gonna explain din those that were not. I'm gonna explain the new meaning ng word Foolish and Virgin. Virgin, ano yung black word right here? Is a word for those that will be purified by Christ. Foolish is a word for those wicked. Okay? When these two words are together, it means the person is in a climax of his life. For example, climax, he is in a split decision of his life. He could lose his foolishness and become wise. Even in the tribulation period, or he maintains his foolishness. Sabi sa Daniel 12:10 is wicked yan, ha? Wicked and foolish. If you don't know, you don't become wise, you will become wicked. The foolish will lose their virginity. They will no longer be called virgin.
Wicked.
2 Corinthians 11, 2 and 3. So I am jealous over you with godly jealousy. For I have espoused you to one husband, which is Christ. For I have espoused you as a chaste virgin to Christ. Chaste virgin.
Chaste virgin, yeah. Foolish. Yeah, okay.
As now, but I fear that by any means, as the serpent beguiled Eve, so does as the serpent beguiled Eve, so your mind would be corrupted. Let's talk about virginity. Virginity can be corrupted. So, common sense in this world, if you remain foolish, babae, sa babae, manatili siya foolish, sama siya sa disco, gimit-gimit, yung pag-boyfriend, walang training, no? Kung training, oh, wala virginity niya. Because foolishness. That's talking.
Hindi virginity siya.
Oo. In example to, pag hindi ka nag-wise, you will lose your virginity. So we have children today, mga anak, at home. They're still virgins, but they're not yet knowledgeable. I'm not yet talking spiritual, I'm talking physical. So itong mga anak natin na virgin pa, hindi naman naaralas o hindi nagiging wise, no? Mawawala ang kanila tatagal. So temporary condition niya, temporary situation niya. Foolish and virgin as a word together is temporary. Either she will lose her foolishness or she will lose her virginity. These two cannot go together forever. These two can go together temporarily in the beginning. So, the wise virgin, may pinagdaanan na yan. If you notice the wise virgin sa story, they already bought oil from the marketplace. Nauna na sila. The foolish don't want to buy oil. Tinatamad sila. Pwede na to, sapaka to sa amin. Okay? But later, they will still buy oil. But they will miss the wedding. What is the wedding? The wedding of the bridegroom and the bride. So, there are people that will be left behind in the tribulation that will die. If they will repent from their foolishness. Kahabol sila maging ganayan. Okay? But the message na habulin nila, mababaw nila. Yung three angels message nga, yung everlasting gospel. Mababaw na lang yan. Hindi na yung ganyan mga detalye. These are only reserved for the bride, the lamb's wife. If the wedding garment is fine linen. So there will be people that will be saved that will be just be given white robes. Okay? They will die in the tribulation. Let's open our Bible. Revelation chapter 7.
That's what it means as like the foolish.
That's the other, the five, the foolish. I'm talking about the foolish. that will become wise. The weak, the one become wicked, pareho na sa explanation. No? I'm just explaining yung mga saying. Dati siyang foolish, okay? Chapter 7, verse 9.
Pagkatapos nito, nakita ko ang napakaraming taong di kayang bilangin na inuman. Sila'y mula sa bawat bansa, lahi, bayan at wika. Nakatayo sila sa harap ng trono at ang kordero'y nakadamit ng puti na may hawak ng mga palaspas.
14.
Pa? Hindi ko po alam, sugun ko. Kayo ang nakaalam at sinabi niya sa akin, sila ang mga nagtagumpay sa kabila ng mahigpit na pag-uupi. Nilinis nila at pinaputi sa dugo ng kordero ang kanilang damit.
So lumabas sila sa dakilang kahirapan. They came out of great tribulation. That's another scripture for this foolish that have repented to become wise. Revelation chapter 11, Revelation chapter 12, verse 11. Pagkabasa, 12, 11. Pagkabasa, Revelation chapter 12, verse 11.
Sister, ikaw, you read. Para kita na boyfriend mo sa YouTube.
They overcame him by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony. They did not love their lives so much as to shrink from death.
Okay, there will come a time, sabi ni Barbara Nam, a squeezing time dito sa earth. That will be the tribulation. Aside from God pouring out his wrath 7 years dito sa earth, the Antichrist will rule the world and will persecute those that carry the message of the two prophets. So, as they persecute and they were killed, yan yung characteristic na foolish that became wise. Nag-repent sila. And they were saved. They did not love their lives unto death. Similar sa nabasa natin sa chapter 7. Let's read another scripture, chapter 20, verse 4.
Revelation
24.
20 verse 4. Sister, ikaw, you read.
Para nakakita ako ng mga trono at ng mga nakasuklok doon ay binigyan ng karapatan umatol. Nakita ko rin ang kaluluwa ng mga pinugutan dahil sa pagpapatot ko. Tungkol kay Jesus, pag-alayag ng salita ng Diyos. Hindi sila sumamba sa limaw o sa larawang ito. Hindi tumanggap man ang patak ng kalimaw sa kanilang loob. So, pamayang pinuhay sila upang lumalikas, magayos kasama ni Kristo sa loob ng sanliman.
So, their death was near millennium, no? Before they ruled the city, they were killed. The tribulation. They did not receive the mark and they were killed for it. You know, Christians here in the church ages, I'm going to use an illustration.
These are illustrations.
No,
let's give them away later.
I'm going to show the church ages. This is the church ages. Okay, if you can close it up.
Camera.
The church ages. Not all people are killed for the mark. But let's go to the tribulation period. Pause muna. Now, this is the church ages. Okay? This is the tribulation period. Okay? This is the tribulation
period. If you want, he will give you later on zero stopping.
Sir, pwede niyo i-color. Hindi ko nakuha i-color. Tagal na, long time ago. Okay, so... This tribulation period is the last week of Daniel. This is where, yun nabasa nyo, they were killed for the testimony. They were killed for their faith. Their heads were chopped off because they did not accept the mark of the beast. Here in the church ages, there are people that did not accept the mark of the beast, but they were not killed. Diba? This is the church ages.
Panahon ng seven churches.
The seven church ages are 2,000 years from the first coming of Christ to the second coming of Christ.
Yeah.
These 2,000 years, people experience tribulation, people experience death, persecution, but not all. Not all. There are people that died in peace. Okay? There are the rebel apostles left. But here, you will die for your faith. Yeah. The whole world. Okay. In our generation is the world globalized. When you say globalized, they're networking together to catch terrorists. Okay? And naiwan, bakit sila naiwan? They were pushing. They were left in the second phase of the first resurrection. And they will suffer martyrdom for their faith. Okay? So, okay. So much for that. Let's continue.
How do you feel now after having darling in your mouth? You feel better?
Yeah. My stomach is also better.
Oh yeah. If you drink three times, you will be all right. I will help you.
Right now I'm all right.
Yes.
Okay. So, okay, that's the answer. The midnight prayer later. I'm going to stop it. Let's ask more questions.
Last 5 minutes. We take lunch, then we get.
Who wish to ask questions? Last 5 minutes? Pause muna ako ng question.
Okay, start.
Ano mo lang yung pinakamadali na sa
Tagalogin? Dalawa.
The reason why she likes Tagalog, she wants these people will understand. That's the only reason.
Okay,
yes, she knows so, English.
The original Godhead teaching, the deity of Christ is because of the indwelling of the Father in Him.
Amen.
And becoming one with the Spirit.
Amen.
Kaya ay pagka-Diyos si Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Dahil nanahan ang kapusmusan ng ama kanya at naging isa sa kanyang Espiritu. Yan ang nakasulat sa Biblia.
Listen.
The Bible. Okay? Pero we can trace from history, makikita natin sa nakalipas, paano na-develop ang Trinity? Na-develop lang yan eh. Dalawang naglaban, Trinity, oneness, Arianism, subordinationism, and non-practice. Pero the true Godhead nawala. It disappeared. Why it disappeared? The church went into the dark ages. It's the most important doctrine as yan yung unang-unang binago.
Yeah.
So, later what you see, later then, this is the original.
That's the heart of the teaching.
Yes.
Puso
na.
Yan
ang basic one niya ng Catholic Church.
Yes, basic na ng Catholic Church.
Basic Catholic
wala pa Catholic Church. Catholic Church did not yet exist. They changed the Godhead. What after
that?
Yes, they got it. After the Godhead was changed into Trinity, then the Catholic Church started to organize that. Then, parang ipinamanap sa Catholic Church through Constantine. Okay? So, later, I'm gonna go into this. Sinabi ko lang yung shortcut. The deity of Jesus Christ is not because He is another person, God, or He's God the Father. It's because God was dwelling in Him. He is the Son of God, the Son of Man, a vessel indwelled by God. And that vessel is a pure man, a sinless man like the first Adam. Okay.
Thank you. Okay. Tapos na. We will close it. We will eat. We will sit down again. Okay, sir. Nobody allowed to go home. We have to sit because we invited him. So, tapos na. Let's be close now. Para on the time. 12 o'clock. Tama, Lola? 12 o'clock. Gusto niya, Lola? Exactly time close. You keep yourself. Okay?
Let's be close our program. And the tayo. We will invite again if you are willing. He will come again and teach us. You will be good students of Bible. You will be